Welcome to the 40-gallon water change on the 90-gallon freshwater low-tech planet aquarium. This is my first voiceover, and we'll see how it goes. The video is about 20 minutes or so, and we have a quick cleaning of the glass. And it's been a while since I've cleaned this tank. I want to say March sometime. It's definitely been at least 2 or 3 months. And so what you're seeing there, there's a 20-gallon brute trash can. We're going to fill it up twice. And basically half the tank is vacuum grabbed, and the other half you'll see. So as far as update on the livestock, still one discus in the tank along with several different species of tetras, and so as you can see with the vacuum, it is pretty dirty in the substrate there. I did switch out my pumps. I'm no longer using the Hydor pumps. I switched them out for the Tunze. I believe that one in the upper left-hand corner is a 6D15. And pretty simple setup. No CO2 on this tank, but I'm hoping to add CO2 in the future now that I have purchased a calcium reactor for the 75-gallon saltwater aquarium, which I will have a sneak look at it. Mostly Java fern and Anubias in this tank. The driftwood is Malaysian driftwood. Two different types of substrate. And yeah, hopefully I'll be putting some more fish in the tank. It is hopefully going to be sticking mainly with tetras, but I would like to add some rams to the tank. The cleanup crew, I do need some more snails for this tank too. So a little bit through this, we did speed up the video, and so as you can see, the water level is starting to drop. Quiet for a little bit. I'm gonna restart the siphon. Alright, so we're still on the first 20 gallons. And as far as the aquascape, I basically tried to leave that area that I'm cleaning right now as kind of like a pathway towards the back. So you'll see me clean that out. Same lights on the tank. I have Marineland LEDs, and there's 2 units in which was overkill for this setup, but so basically I use 1 unit in the morning and then 1 unit in the afternoon to spread out the I guess the wear and tear on the LEDs, but things have been going good. I did take the Fuval 406 canister offline, and both AquaClear 110s are offline. The tank is coming up on 5 years, so it's very mature, and I basically, you can see right there the air bubbles, I basically run this tank solely on water changes and the Whisper, I think it's 150 air pump. Just for, you know, water circulation, I'm using the Tunze pump, and that's pretty much it. There's one heater all the way in the background. It is currently the 200-watt Fuval eSeries heaters, which I run exclusively on all my aquariums. And So normally in the winter time there is a 200 watt and a 300 watt, and then that same exact setup is on the saltwater tank, which is not 90 gallons, it's actually 75 gallons, but has a total water volume of 90 gallons, and so I run a 200 watt and also a 300 watt Fuval eSeries. And then on my quarantine tank or hospital tank, I think it's like a 50 watt or 100 watt Fuval eSeries heater. If anyone watching this video has experience with those heaters, please leave a comment down below, let me know. They've worked well for me, and they're not the most expensive, but they're also not titanium, and they are not the cheapest. And they do have a nice digital readout, which is a nice double check against other temperature readers. So yeah, we're coming up on the end of the first 20 gallon here. And let's see, we still have the video sped up here. Trying to think what else. I always clean, I shouldn't say always, I do my best to clean the glass tops that are on this. They get pretty dirty and end up blocking the light, so I do clean those with I guess just vinegar and water solution. Alright, so that right there is the first 20 gallons, and plucking out, you saw there a piece of I guess foil that comes off of those frozen cubes. And so over here on the right hand side, I am cleaning the glass. And those two containers that you see at the top, those really come in handy. I think one is like the small and the other one is the large. I forget what they're called, but they're the same containers that you see in fish stores. I believe they're by Tom Aquaponics or something like that. I'll see if I can put a link in the description below. But they come really in, really handy, so because they hang on the side of the tank, and you can actually use the large one if you punch holes through it as a in-tank quarantine. So there's a lot of different uses for those containers, and they're relatively inexpensive. So right here you see me just kind of pulling out a bunch of algae that has started to clump up and mat on top of some of the plants. So what we're waiting on here is, you can't see this off screen at the bottom, but the water that was just pumped out that's sitting in that 20 gallon brute container at the bottom of the screen that you may or may not be able to see, that is currently being pumped down the drain through a strainer that I use on the end, on the outlet. The strainer that I use is the SeaChem, the bag. I'm not sure what the micron is, but it helps catch any additional, helps keep any additional debris from going down the drain. Believe it or not, most of these fish actually came from PetCo, which is now owned by liveaquaria, and the same thing for my freshwater tank. It's sometimes they get a bad rap, sometimes rightly so, for the conditions that we've probably all have seen at our local fish shops. But my experience has been well, and so here we are on the second 20 gallons. So on this part, we're going to be focusing mainly on the right-hand side of the tank. Very similar process, which I'm currently blocking the view of the tank, but I'll move in a second. There we go. So yeah, I have challenges where when I set up both these tanks, I unfortunately put some items a little bit too close to the glass, so it's one thing I have to be mindful of, is to make sure I leave room. So we got a siphoning the substrate in the back, and right back there is where the heater is laying horizontally out of sight, and it works well with the heater on that side and the wave maker on the other side. There's also an outlet for one of the air stones back there. So we're just cleaning this out. I have to do a video on how I got into the aquarium hobby. I've done freshwater aquariums ever since I was 8 years old, 8 or 7. Actually, one of my teachers up in New Jersey was kind of the catalyst that got me introduced to them. So this is actually 40 gallons, so it's a 90-gallon Aquion tank, and we have taken 40 gallons out, and that's the line there. I used to take another 20 gallons, but I stopped doing that. It just wasn't necessary, and it stressed out the fish. So we're getting ready to drain that last remaining 20 gallons, and we're going to be filling the tank back up with... I used to use RODI water, then I realized it was a little bit overkill, wasn't really necessary. And so I sometimes mix RODI with tap, but mainly I use tap water and Seachem Prime. And it doesn't take long. This whole process is like, you know, a half hour, maybe an hour, between a half hour and an hour, but usually it takes about 45 minutes or so, depending on if I have my full attention. So here's a slow-mo shot of all the crap that I pulled out of the aquarium in that container that I was showing you. Quick shot of the saltwater tank, which is doing good. Got some updates coming on that. Speeding up the video, probably simply turning up the music a little bit. Once the water starts, the outlet for the fresh water coming into the tank will be in the upper right hand corner. So I'll come over and turn it so it's not like all over that plant right there. So here's the side of the glass, and we're will speed up the video, and I'll see you on the other side. Alright, so tank has been filled back up and we're just repositioning the wave maker. And here's the final result. So yeah, it's not much of an aquascape, but I do like it. If you notice up top, I did add a auto feeder, and so we will close out with a close-up of the discus, and thanks for watching, and until next time.